In this video, we will tell you method to save income tax on your profit made through share market income. To save tax, it is important to know some basics about capital gain taxation. So watch the complete video to learn the tax saving method. We will discuss step by step how tax is calculated on capital gain, then how we show this in our ITR income tax return, and then at the last, how we can do the tax planning. Now, first we need to understand types of gains. Basically three types: short term, long term, and intraday. What is short term? When you hold the shares up to 12 months, that is up to 1 year if you are holding any shares, then it is short term. More than 1 year, it is known as long term capital gain. And then whatever we do that intraday, buy and sell on the same day, that is intraday. Okay, so basically three types of gain: short term capital gain, long term capital gain, and intraday. Up to 1 year short term, more than 1 year long term, intraday buy and sell within the same day. Now, short term is taxable under the capital gain head. You might be knowing there are five heads of income: salary, house property, business and profession, that is PGBP, capital gain, and other sources. So short term is taxable under the head capital gain. Long term is also taxable under the head capital gain. Intraday, it is taxable under business and profession. I repeat, intraday is taxable under business and profession, that is PGBP, as speculative business income. However, practically many investors show that under short term capital gain, as short term capital gain, but it has to be taxable under the head speculative business income. Lastly, dividend income, it is taxable under the head other sources. Next week in our video, we will tell you how you can save tax on your dividend income also. Moving ahead, these are the tax rate. Now, understand, tax is on profit, right? Sale price minus purchase price, not on the whole sale amount. So what is the tax rates? For short-term capital gain, it is 15%. For long-term capital gain, up to 1 lakh, it is zero, nil. Let's say you made a capital gain, long-term capital gain of 80,000, no tax. But long-term capital gain more than 1 lakh, then you have to pay 10% on the excess of 1 lakh. Suppose you made a profit of 1,20,000. So you have to pay 10% on 20,000 only. Only on the excess of 1 lakh. Okay. Next, intraday, as it is taxable under the head PGBP, it has to be paid as per the slab rate. Dividend income, taxable under other sources, is also at slab rate. Remember, we need to pay the health and education cess at the rate 4%, which is additional in all the above cases that we have to pay. So this was about the tax rate. You will see the summary once again. For the short term, 15%. Long term, two categories: up to 1 lakh, 0. Above 1 lakh, 10%. Dividend as per the slab rate. Intraday also as per the slab rate. Now we will see about the losses. Many a times investor make some losses in the share market. These losses can be carried forward for 8 years. So what is this, the benefit of loss? Let's say in 1920 you had a loss of 2 lakh rupees in the share market. You can claim this 2 lakh next year in 2021 in case you are having a profit. So in 1920 you made a loss of 2 lakh. but in 2021 you made a profit of 6 lakh. So you can adjust, set off this 2 lakh with 6 lakhs. So on balance 4 lakh, you need to pay the tax. So this is the benefit of losses. But to claim this loss, you have to file the income tax return on time, right? So filing of income tax return on time is important to carry forward the losses. So if any year you have lost, still file the income tax return so that you can claim the benefit next year. And this can be actually carried forward for 8 years. Intraday, it can be carried forward for the 4 years only. Few more important thing about losses. Short-term losses can be set off against short-term or long-term gains, right? Short-term losses can be set off against short-term or long-term gains, but long-term losses can be set off only against long-term capital gains only. Intraday losses can be set off against only intraday gain. Now about the ITRs, ITR 1 cannot be used to show your share market income. You need to file ITR 2, 3 or 4 as per your business or salary head you are having. So ITR 1 cannot be used. You have to fill in the details under short term capital gain section 111E. You can get the capital gain report from your brokers. Below the broker report, you will find there is a sale figure given. So you can write the sale figure as full value of consideration in the ITR and purchase figure in the cost of acquisition. Similarly, 112A for long-term capital gain. So if you have bought shares after this date, you can show this consolidated figure. You do not have to show about each and every figure. I mean to say, you have to show the consolidated figure of all the shares. You do not have to disclose about each shares. You have bought this share on this date and sold on this date. Not required if you have bought the shares after 31 January 2018. But if you have bought the shares before 31st March 18, then you have to show the details share wise, each share wise, right? With the ISIN code of that share. So this was the basic. Now we come to the main thing, how we can save tax. Is it actually possible to save taxes on capital gain? Yes, it is possible and many people are doing this. So it's a very simple trick. Instead of doing regular trading through your account, you can do the trading on your family member's DMAT account. What is the benefit? They can claim the basic exemption up to 2,50,000. So if you are making any profit up to 2,50,000, you do not have to pay any income tax. There will be no income tax. We will see this with an example. Let's say there is a Mr. X. He has a salary income of 7 lakhs and he made 2 lakhs short-term capital gain. Now on 7 lakhs, he will pay as per the slab rate, and on this 2 lakh, he will pay 15%. So he will end up paying taxes of 85,800. Now we see Mr. Y. What he does is, he has a salary income of 7 lakhs, but he do the trading in his wife's account. So Mrs. Y has earned 2 lakhs. Now on the 7 lakhs, Y paid a tax of 54,600. And on this 2 lakh, Mrs. Y do not have to pay any income tax. She is paying zero tax because up to 2,50,000, there is no taxes. So we can see X has paid 85,800, wherein Y and family has paid just 54,600. So Y has saved 31,200 rupees just with this tax planning. So you can also do this tax planning and save income tax. Now we will tell you the second method. If you have a very big long-term capital gain, right? The amount is huge. Let's say you made a 100x or 200x on some shares. You have bought some shares 20 years back, and now you are making a huge profit, long-term capital gain. Is it possible that we can save tax on your 40, 50 lakhs of your capital gain that you have made? Yes, it is possible. What are the conditions? You are either individual or HUF, and you own just one house or no house. You do not have any home or just one home. And what you have to do, whatever was the sale amount of the shares that you have sold, you need to invest that sale amount into buying a new residential property within 2 years. Or if you are making a construction, then within 3 years. So whatever the sale, I am not saying just the profit amount. Let's say you bought a share for 10 lakhs and now you are selling that share at 60 lakhs. So you made a profit of 50 lakhs. To claim this exemption, you need to buy the new residential property of 60 lakhs, the complete sale amount. That too within 2 years, if you are purchasing, and if you are construction, then 3 years. Also, please note there will be a condition that you cannot sell this new residential house property for next 3 years. So if you buy, you cannot sell this new property for 3 years. So your amount will be blocked. So you need to plan this accordingly. So this was the two major ways by which you can save your taxes on capital gain made through share market income. Hope our video will help you to plan and save tax on share market profits. Thank you.